and Pats does countdown. Jon Richardson, Jonathan Ross, Johnny Vegas, Michelle Wolf, Pappy, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
Hello and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, hurkle-durkle is an old Scottish term meaning to lounge in bed all day? Hey, Scottish people, you can't lie in bed all day, unless, of course, you've given the Domino's delivery guy his own key. The food you take on a picnic is called picnickery, whereas the photos I text your mum are called dick-pickery. And onomatomania is frustration at not being able to think of a word. And it can be especially frustrating if the word you can't remember is your safe word. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's Jon Richardson. Jon Richardson, he puts the great into the phrase whiny, grating voice. John's teammate, Michelle Wolf. Before finding fame on The Daily Show in America, Michelle worked on Wall Street. So her surname is Wolf, and she used to work on Wall Street. She's just like that film. Annie. Up against them this evening, it's special guest team captain, Jonathan Ross. Jonathan owns a number of exotic pets, including an iguana. Brightly coloured, with soft, leathery skin and a bulging neck, Jonathan is one of the most distinctive faces on television.
Well, very funny, Jimmy, but the iguana's dead. In new ways, Dave as a joke, you are a terrible person.
I went for iguana, you went with...
Dave.
What, how did you pronounce iguana?
Well, it had its iguana.
Okay. You did say iguana the first time.
I preferred iguana. I thought you were getting it right. I thought you would know.
He's dead! Does it matter?
And joining Jonathan tonight, it's Johnny Vegas. Johnny Vegas has show business running through his veins, as well as dangerously high levels of saturated fat.
You've all come back to butter. I was mocked during the margarine years.
Your love of butter. I mean, you say what you want, you've outlived Prince and David Bowie. Who would have thought it?
Only because I'm younger.
You are?
Oh, wow. OK, we're not standing for that.
What was your luxury Gaviscon? I remember when I first met you, you were taking Gaviscon, but luxury Gaviscon that you were making yourself.
It's two-part Baileys, one-part Cointreau.
And you were drinking, if I'm not mistaken, pints of?
Well, I had a lot of reflux. So,
Jonathan, this is your first time being a captain on Cats Does Countdown. Yes. How are you going to motivate Johnny?
Well, I don't think I need to motivate Johnny, because I didn't see your previous appearance on the show, but I said I'll be captain as long as you give me a team, the team itself, if we're really crackerjack at what we do. And they've said that Johnny is excellent at all things in this game. Have they misinformed me, Johnny? Have you won of the previous shows you've been on?
It's not about winning, it's about building to this. It's about building to this moment, isn't it?
But they did say he was very good. Is he?
He's never scored a single point. And he's been on the show eight times.
Because they said he was the best, so he's the best at not scoring. I see. Okay.
Well, great company after the show.
I lull John into a false sense of security, and you attack.
Okay.
Question: do you have names other than John?
It does seem like a fair point. Yeah. We thought we'd make it super simple for you. We weren't expecting one of those smart Americans.
Would you like to give us John 1, John 2 and John 3? Or Big John, Little John, Dull John? Would you like to add something?
I have no idea how to pick Big John, Little John and Dull John.
Yes, you do.
Johnny, have you got a game plan for the evening?
Write stuff down.
Write stuff down, yeah.
And write, like, write the stuff that's up there down. Don't just write things down and look busy. In a big office. You kind of can't get away with it now. This is like, it's more of an appraisal.
Michelle, do you know who any of us are?
No, I thought, when I saw you, I thought maybe Benedict Cumberbatch had gotten in a terrible accident.
The really hurtful thing about that is I sort of take that as a compliment. Just to be mentioned in the same sentence, I'm thrilled. OK, what do you think of your team captain, John? What do you make of him?
Seems a little school shootery, but other than that...
Yes! Yes, right? He does! Because it's always the quiet ones.
Yeah.
Michelle, do any British words or phrases confuse you?
Oh, almost everything Johnny said. It took me a solid minute and a half to realise he was talking about butter.
I once chatted to a girl in a bar in San Francisco for half an hour, and she said that my voice was one of the most melodic that she'd ever heard.
Did she just get the ability to hear?
Confess that she hadn't understood, as you, a single word I'd said.
OK, John, have you ever done something and thought, I'm never doing that again?
Oh, yeah, I've made some big mistakes in my life. I once bought the same squash twice in a row. That stuck with me. I'd enjoyed the orange and mango and I thought, do you know what? I'll have that one again. And then you're stuck with it. It's a long time to get through a bottle of squash. I should have gone summer fruits. You always go purple, orange, purple, orange, purple, orange.
What is this squash? I thought you were talking about the vegetable.
No, what would you call it? Dilute juice?
You would probably say that. You'd probably say, dilute juice!
Orange fucking cordial.
I don't know what American does this.
Okay, now, Jonathan, have you got a mascot this evening?
Yeah, I have got a mascot. That's what bringing a mascot. I bought a mascot in. I bought something quite rare. As you know, I'm a collector. I collect comic books, love all things like that. And I also collect toys. I have a particular frame of reference, Japanese toys from the 1960s and 1970s. In particular, the toys from the companies Bulmak, Poppy, Gogokin, and Takara.
Sorry, are you also a part-time snooker referee?
Well, no, because this is a very valuable little item I'm bringing out for you, and I'm showing it the respect it deserves if I can get my glove on.
Are we playing airport again?
No. OK, so this is Takara Mikuro Man from 1970. He's about 50 years old, so his hips aren't as strong as they used to be. Okay, and these come from a Mikuro Man, which we would pronounce Micro Man.
Oh, these are the original Micro Man.
Yeah, these are the original ones. And what I love about them, A, they're incredibly great toys. They're a beautiful-looking little toy. But when they bought out about 10 in the first one. So the Japanese company gave them all names. Can you guess what this one's name was?
Is it Jeff? Because he looks like he's dragging two bags and he's coming out the airport and his taxi's not arrived.
You're not far on, though. His name was George.
Can I have a look at him?
You can, but don't break him with your big fingers.
His joints are just rather unfortunate. He just looks like me leaving a pub.
He's quite old.
As alpha.
You don't need to do the voice, Johnny. Johnny, have you got a mascot? What have you brought?
Well, I rifled through a skip, and I found this.
That's my
mascot. Yeah, it's Michelle in her college years. This was before you had your other leg lengthened. You have the same disdain for look. Every time I open my mouth, it's like 50% of your brain goes, we can rest. I do like his cuffs. He's always dressed for dinner.
He's a wonderful thing. You should see my rescue base.
I've seen your rescue base.
I've got two beam triplers never removed from boxes. Boom.
There's a morality issue that aren't toys created to be played with.
not the
that
ones
that
I've
That sounded like
got.
The saddest line from a movie. What toy is supposed to be play with?
What Dickensian era did I know? What toy supposed to be played with?
I think she's just nailed you, is what's happened. Michelle, have you got a mascot?
I do. I was sort of missing home, so I asked for a gun. and instead, they brought me this baby taser. It's not for babies. Yeah. It's small. And then they filled it with my favorite Tennessee whiskey.
<It's>... have you just got whiskey in your eye?
It's real whiskey. So. That was...
Well, that is not at all suggestive.
Oh, God, it is.
I'm all right, I'm driving. I'm driving our team to victory. Since my shit-faced colleague, probably.
Okay, Jon, have you got a mascot?
Yes. Well, it's more of a celebration, Jimmy.
Oh, well, fantastic.
Of yeah. course, we all know that... Bake Off is coming to Channel 4.
Of course.
Have a special Bake Off. I am Marquee Mark. This is very exciting for me. It's like a sort of World Cup coming to the town I live in. I didn't want you to be left out, Jimmy, so I've made you a cake I thought you would like. This is a pound cake. Although since Brexit, it's slightly less than a pound.
I've recently learned that half of that pound cake needs to go to the taxman. I can't accept it all.
Well, I'll take it.
For Susie, I made a tiramisu. It's basically an ordinary tiramisu, but well read.
If you like tiramisu and puns, you're in luck, Susie.
Three spoons, I'm afraid, so one of you can't have tiramisu. And I want it finished by the end of the show.
I didn't think you could look any more nerdy, but you've done it.
And these are for you two. I didn't want you to be left out. So these are some profiteroles.
Wow, thank you, John.
Thank you.
You can enjoy those. They're proper profiteroles. They're good and tasty, and they're lined with a laxative filling. It's inspired by the Bible quote, "What shall it profit a roll if we make a few pounds but lose our arsehole?" So I thought, if you eat a few of them, you'll shit your pants and we'll win.
Jon Richardson's cake to everyone. Some excellent cake to share.
No use for the bun.
OK, over in Dictionary Corner, we've got Pappies.
Oh, yes.
Now, you're in Dictionary Corner tonight. Which one of you is the cleverest?
Well, you're dyslexic.
Yes.
Yeah.
So it's going to be a long night for you in Dictionary Corner.
Yeah. I'm just going to sing along to the clock.
Nice. I think I'm probably... I sort of look like I might be the cleverest. Yeah. I've got...
The glasses.
And these... I do need these. I had to take a test to get these and fail that test. I do need the glasses, yeah. But I think Tom is probably the cleverest.
Oh.
He's a sort of kind of philosopher-type character.
Yeah, he's always coming up with sayings like that one about the weather.
Got a great saying about the weather, Jimmy.
Go ahead.
Red sky at night, shepherd's delight. Blue sky at night, day.
Yeah. Okay, and with Pappies, of course, it's Susie Dent.
Oh. Yeah!
In October, Susie released her 14th book. Well, you know what they say, if at first you don't succeed, keep on releasing boring books. Susie, you've written a book recently about the secret languages of Britain. Can you tell us some of your favourites?
Yes. Well, I had to hang out with different groups of people who share a sort of common language. So I had bin men. I had a great day out with bin men. And they call maggots disco rice, which I love. I really like that. And they also talk, if they're cleaning the street, they talk about getting it up. So having a really good day getting it up is
I bet they were when you were there, Susan. And in charge of the numbers is Rachel Riley. Rachel Riley has a degree from Oxford, and her tutors have a degree of sadness when they think about her chosen career path. Rachel, what's the best and worst chat-up line anyone's ever tried on you?
Well, the worst chat-up line I've heard is, I've got a purple dome that needs a home.
You know what, Rachel? If you're not interested, just say you're not interested.
It was in text form. My friend made the mistake of letting me play Tinder on her phone.
Played Tinder?
Yeah.
What was the best chat-up line? Was there any good chat-up lines?
I can't remember. No, I mean, that's the one that sticks in my mind.
I've got a little mouse that needs a house.
OK, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Ball Pit.
Yes.
Jonathan and Johnny, you get the first pick of the letters.
Johnny, should we do this together?
OK. A letter, please.
B. C.
And another letter, please.
You. Oh,
consonants! Consonants!
Oh. Let's have another consonant.
M.
Oh. And, vowel?
A.
Not a vowel, please.
I.
Consonant.
S.
Another vowel. We're going to go for another vowel, and then should we round it off with a consonant?
With a consonant.
Yes, please.
R.
OK, and for the first time today, here's the countdown clock.
Kalmizer. What the?
Jonathan, how many letters?
I remember that's how we first met, when you wanted to get in the show business.
I made it, Ma.
I've got a bunch of fives, but I haven't got... I've got fives and fives.
Bunch of fives. OK. What about Johnny? How many you got?
I've got a seven.
Yes. Well, how many have you actually got?
I've got a seven.
Yeah, he has. Got
seven. Oh, OK. Well, John, how many have you got?
Don't look at me like that, John.
John, what have you got?
I've got a Bake Off six.
A Bake Off six.
Yeah.
And Michelle, what have you got?
I've got a boring six, but a fun three.
Okay, Jonathan, why one of your fives?
I've got miser, laser, curls.
Okay, Michelle, your six?
Claims.
Claims. John, your six?
It's how you stop a mini shoe bun becoming a profiterole. Creams.
Thanks, John. You've just provided the ultimate distraction for the rest of the show for me. Yeah. You know I'm obese, and you've just thrown a cake in my eye, mate. Every ounce of my being wants to crawl over this desk now and rescue me.
Johnny, what's your seven?
You see, I had claims, the same, and then, obviously, the letters weren't there to make claimant, but is claimer a word?
Claimer?
This could be the best Johnny has ever done.
You see? You see?
Oh!
Yes! Seven. You think that the best thing going for you?
Yes.
OK, Pappy, Susie, could they have done any better than a seven?
There's a few eights, actually.
Oh, there would be, wouldn't
there? Yeah, sorry, mate. Yeah. Clumsier. I mean, you could have got that.
Oh, yeah.
Clumsier there. Susie, any more?
Yeah, reclaims. You could have turn claimer around. But pretty good to get a seven in. Yeah.
Really good.
I'm impressed.
Really good.
Well done.
It's like that kid who's just bad at school, innit? And he has that one day to shine. And you go, still very good. Now you can stop burning things to the ground.
So at the end of that, Jonathan and Johnny are in the lead with 7 points. OK, on to our first numbers round. John, Michelle, your turn to pick the numbers.
Oh, I know how to do this, for sure.
OK, go ahead.
Top.
I'm enjoying it, one word at a time. If you want to look like a sort of old Countdown hand, do you say something like a 1-2-1-2 or an inverted T or something?
What?
I don't want to come off as that big of a nerd.
We'll just say something like,
oh, some big uns and some small uns.
Do you like little ones or big ones?
One big one?
Fuck it, I don't even give a shit. I don't... I'm not being the nerd. I don't care, Rachel.
One big one, five.
Put some letters and a picture of a meadow up there. Yeah.
You all ready for this?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
You ready for this? Some numbers on a board, Rachel. Get over yourself. Are you ready for this?
Five.
I got an 8, I got a 6, I got a 5. Are you ready? I think we'll be all right.
One. Oh,
I wasn't expecting a 1. Jesus.
And 100.
Oh,
and the target. Oh, Jesus.
Don't change it. You did this before and you changed it on me when I got it.
That's
I
changed.
Can get that. No, don't change it.
Why? Okay, your target is 687. Your time starts now. So the target was 687. John, I'm taking it by the fact you had 2 profiteroles that you got that.
Yeah, we did.
OK. And Michelle, did you get it?
I did.
OK, Johnny, did you get it?
Almost.
Almost. You were just 687 away.
I got 686, obviously, cos I forgot I'd already used the 6.
OK. Jonathan, did you get it?
Well, I did it wrong, because...
That's a no, then, isn't it?
Well, no. I got confused again, I got so excited, and I was trying to get 587, and I got really close. So, in a way, I got it.
Well, Michelle, how did you do it?
I actually used the 6 twice, so I didn't get it.
John, how did you get it?
6 plus 1.
7.
Times by 100.
700.
Minus 8, minus 5.
Yep.
10 points to John. OK, so Jonathan and Johnny have 7. John and Michelle have 10.
You could have got that.
And here's your teaser. The words are nude snog. The clue is they're wet and dirty. That's nude snog. They're wet and dirty. See you after the break. To the tease, the words were nude snog. The clue was they're wet and dirty. It was, of course, dungeons. So, John and Michelle are in the lead. OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Johnny and Michelle. So, Michelle, your turn to choose the letters.
Don't let
All right, Michelle,
don't let
good,
get in
listen,
there.
Just good luck.
OK?
Welcome to the UK. And enjoy. And I had a perm once, so... How was it?
Is yours a natural curl?
Natural, yeah.
Oh, do you use a diffuser?
How do you know so much about beauty? Okay, I have 2 vowels.
Sure.
O, A, then 1 more vowel, and then the rest consonant.
That'll do. O.
No, wait. I want 1 more vowel.
Yeah.
Intake of breath.
E, T, and. L.
OK, and your time starts
Hang on.
Now.
And
Does anyone fancy a kebab?
Is it vegetarian?
It's not vegetarian, but I've got... Yeah, if you take those...
Oh, no, I'm going to have to...
It's not vegetarian, but it's not any meat you've ever heard of either.
It's a shame, because since I gave up meat, sweating mechanically reconstituted flesh is my favourite kind.
Oh, what? I got you this, because I know you're vegetarian.
Oh, cheers.
You enjoy.
Come
I'm a mum.
Do you want... Iceberg, dead ahead!
One, two, three. Yeah. Susie doesn't want it.
I know I wasn't in that round, Jimmy, but I seem to have ended up with some good lettuce.
Better take this off, because I look ridiculous. Michelle, how many?
I got a big five.
OK, Johnny?
I got a big five, too.
I've got seven.
You weren't playing. what was your seven?
What was the seven I got?
Ethanol.
OK, Johnny, what was your five?
Phone.
What, sorry?
Phone!
Phone.
E.T. Phone's home.
Phone.
Someone's on the phone here.
Someone's on the phone.
Let's get the phone. Father, London's a lonely place. Yeah, it's raining here. I'll get you, Mum. On the phone.
Michelle, what was your five?
I'm embarrassed to say also phone.
Well, 5 points
about
these.
We are so connected. It's gonna really hurt you when you find out we were separated at birth, isn't it? But you have a twin.
Are you flirting with someone you also think is your sister?
Jesus, no.
Have you never been to the south of your own country?
Fair play.
You've not touched your kebab.
Oh, no, I had a piece.
It's sweating lamb meat.
I don't see the problem with that.
OK, Pappy, Susie, could they have done any better?
Well, Tom was very excited. He thought you could get antelope, and you can't. there is a good eight, which is honeyput. Honeyput, which is my pet name for Jimmy.
It's a variety of Muscat grape. It's from the Dutch meaning cockfoot.
OK, so at the end of that, Jonathan and Johnny have 12. John and Michelle are just in the lead with 15.
Well, that was good.
Right now, time for John and Jonathan to go head-to-head. Jonathan, your turn to pick the numbers.
Numbers? Oh, numbers again?
I know, against John as well.
Can I have an inverted T?
Shit, this guy's played before.
One big, five small, and they are 10, 3, 1, 2, 4, 25.
OK.
And the target, 136.
OK. So your target is 136. Your time starts now. OK, so the target was 136. Jonathan, did you get it?
I'm angry, cos he probably got it. I got 135, but he's probably actually got it. And I can't... It should be impossible to get it.
But you stopped halfway through.
Because I've got 135? That's close enough for a normal person. It's only cos I'm playing a cyborg that I can't get 136. You can't sit me opposite one of Doctor Who's early villains.
John, did you get it?
I think so. I'd got 135 about halfway through, but I thought, let's push on and see if we can get it.
How did you do it?
4 plus 1 is 5.
One.
Yep.
Times by 25. 25. Plus 10. Yeah.
And three,
plus 3 minus 2.
Yeah. And that extra bit of effort.
It's insane. That's crazy talk.
10 points to John. OK, so Jonathan and Johnny have 12. John and Michelle are in the lead with 25. Time now to go across the dictionary corner. Pappy's, what have you got for us?
Well, here in Pappy's, we've been talking to each other a lot about gloves.
Yeah, we're quite obsessed with the subject.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah, so we've got a theory that the kind of gloves a person wears says a lot about who that person really is. And we thought we could test the theory here, tonight...
in song. Leather gloves! Leather gloves! Are you a chauffeur who drives a limousine?
Or maybe you're a Nazi who's acting really mean.
No way! Could be a strangler, strangling who you can.
No, I am an Italian man. Grazie, senorita. Plastic gloves. Plastic gloves.
Now, do you do forensics like on CSI?
No way.
Or a little lady about to use her dye? Or maybe a heart surgeon doing a bypass?
No, I'm a customs officer. I'm gonna probe your ass.
So little time, the gloves keep coming, all different kinds. So you better think twice what you put on your hands, 'cause the glove that he wears says a lot about the man.
Woolen gloves!
Are you at a bonfire with a sparkler that's lit?
I wish.
Or maybe you're the boyfriend of a girl who loves to knit.
No, I'm not even human, that's why your guess is failing. Someone dropped their glove, someone picked it up, and they put it on me. That's right, I'm a railing! I'm a railing guy! White gloves, yeah, you heard me, white gloves, white gloves!
Now, are you a magician? Or are you Mickey Mouse?
No.
Or a snooker umpire at Stephen Hendry's house?
Foul.
Or maybe you're a mime imagining some glass.
No, I am a butler, but I'm gonna probe your ass.
So little time, the gloves keep coming, all different kinds. So you better think twice what you put on your hands, 'cause the glove that he wears says a lot about this man.
Are you a boxer?
Yes, I am a boxer.
Pappies, everyone. And here's your teaser. The words are thin arse. The clue is full of short and curlies. That's thin arse full of short and curlies. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were thin arse. The clue was full of short and curlies. It was, of course, hairnets. Right, before we get on with the game, time for a quick bonus round. Tonight's prize is the Countdown Ball Pit. So Jonathan and John are going to be going head-to-head in the Countdown Ball Pit Challenge. Come and join me. Okay. Come on. OK, I'm going to give each of you a nine-letter word. All you need to do is find the letters that spell out that word in the ball pit. Whoever gets the word first gets the bonus points. OK, Jonathan, your word is poppadoms.
Poppadoms.
So you've got to find poppadoms in there and spell it out there one ball at a time. John, your word is secateurs.
Hey, that guy in the front, I'm waving to you from underneath his ball sack.
OK, all the letters are in the pit somewhere. Good luck. Away you go. OK. Jonathan, you got their first 5 points to Jonathan and Johnny.
Thank you.
OK, well, that was very dignified, gentlemen. Well played. Welcome to British television, Michelle.
I was just noticing how traditional of an English body you have.
In what way?
Long, long, skinny, spindly legs.
I get quite a lot of compliments about my legs from many of the fellas.
What did you think I was built like?
Smart person.
Oh, if I'd have jumped in once more, there'd have been a lot of profiteroles in there.
All right, on with the game. Johnny and Jonathan, your turn to choose the letters.
Let's go with a vowel, please.
Oh. All right.
A vowel, please.
I'm going for a vowel. I want to see where this leads.
You. Yeah. Just different
that
direction.
Can I have another vowel, please?
Eight.
Ooh, we haven't got the one I'm after yet. Could we have one? Could we have the other vowel, please?
Yes.
Yes!
Hey!
A vowel?
Another vowel, please?
Eight.
Do we have to have consonants now?
Yes.
Oh, this game is for squares. Okay, we'll have whatever you need to give us.
I need to take some of those down if we're playing by the rules, but...
You'd rather go with the bad boys.
D-R-M.
Okay, your time starts now. So, Jonathan, how many?
Seven.
Seven?
Maybe.
Johnny, how many?
I've got a five, I think.
John?
Oh, well, I have to go for a seven just to try and match Jonathan.
Wow. Wow, it's on.
Michelle?
I have six, but I'm pretty sure it's not a word.
Oh, what's your six?
Motor. M-O-A-D-E-R.
Motor.
I think I've heard Johnny speak too much.
And what does that mean? Use it in a sentence.
Get in your motor car and let's go to the shops.
Susie, is it a word?
It's not, I'm afraid.
Why you got to be like that, Susie? Johnny, what was your word?
Dream.
Dream. John, your risky seven.
Mordia. As in Mordia.
I'm feeling better about Mordia.
That's not there either.
OK, for the points, Jonathan.
Well, mine might have an E on the end that it doesn't need, so it might only be a six. I've got Maraud, M-A-R-A-U-D-E.
Oh, that would be OK in French, but not in
English. Quel dommage, mon ami.
Oh.
I'm sorry, but it looks like so dreams spiteful. Do come true.
Yeah, dream again!
Susie, could they have done any better?
There were a couple of sevens, Jimmy. Uremia and diorama.
OK, so the scores at the moment, Jonathan and Johnny have 22, John and Michelle have 25.
Oh, ooh,
that's pretty close. And here is your final teaser. The words are rub sadly. The clue is this feels weird. That's rub sadly. This feels weird. See you after the break. Jeez, the words were rub sadly. The clue was this feels weird. It was absurdly. OK, time for our final letters game. John and Michelle, your turn to choose the letters.
You pick, please.
Three vowels?
I'm going to step in.
OK.
The special relationship is over. No, you do it. There's a lot of sugar in those.
How many?
If I'm not very much mistaken, John, you are tired, excited and you're showing off. Yes, you are.
Is there still...
Yeah, there's still...
Oh, yeah, that'll take the edge off the sugar.
A down. many firsts today. consonant?
S.
Another one?
T.
What did you fancy?
Consonant?
Yes.
X.
vowel?
E. Consonant? Yes. R.
And a final?
Confident?
Yeah.
OK, and your 30 seconds starts now. Too big, isn't it? Wow. What have you got, John?
I've got a pin and I've got a seven.
Go on, Jonathan, how many have you got?
I've definitely got seven, but I might have an eight.
What are you going to go for, the seven or the eight?
Why do I have to choose? I'm just. Why can't I just say I've got both? Look, if the eight doesn't work out, give me the seven. Okay. I'm down for the eight. Balls,
okay,
I'm
going for the eight. Johnny?
I've got a seven.
Yeah?
Michelle?
You are not liking this.
I have a seven as well.
You've got a seven as well?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Okay. I'm going to get out of this because I'm losing circulation in my neck and I think that's important, isn't it?
Okay, so, Michelle, you're seven?
Exeters.
Exeters?
Like people that exit.
Susie?
It's not in.
Okay, John, you're seven?
Sexiest.
Johnny, what have you got?
I've got a sexiest.
You've got sexiest?
I went for sexiest.
So you didn't get it.
I had it, look.
Sexiest. Was,
yeah.
Well done, Johnny. OK, Jonathan, what's your risky eight?
Where are we in the scores? If my eight is an actual eight, where are we in the scores right now?
It's a crucial conundrum, whatever no. happens.
Yeah, but how many points do you get if you win the thing? Ten?
Within his right to ask before we go...
Yes, I am within my right.
You know what? You've inspired me. 2 7 letters and a five.
Exactly.
That has never happened.
I've seen
you. You ask what you need to, boss.
OK, well...
If you need anyone's car stolen, I'm your man.
Go on, what have you got?
Sureties.
Sureties.
I didn't think anyone was going to get that. That is brilliant.
Come on!
Thank you. Thank you,
because we couldn't have done that unless we would have done it.
Exactly.
Me you and are you. The wind beneath my wings.
We're like the air team without a van and two other people.
Yeah.
If you use that word in a sentence, it would be, is that something we should look into after in terms of the piece of paper Susie gave to Jonathan? Sure it is.
No one likes a bad loser, John, especially one who's eaten all the cakes and drunk all of Daddy's whiskey.
Johnny, what did you just eat there?
What's the...
Shh. You just... What did you just...
It tastes papery.
What did you say, Jonathan?
No, I just wondered if it tasted papery.
Some evidence being consumed.
No,
there,
no, 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 no.
Wait, we're safe. You can spit out because no one's going to read it.
Okay, so what happened there? What happened there, gents, was Jonathan cheated
what?
And Johnny at the evidence. So 7 points for each team. Okay, so Jonathan and Johnny have 29. John and Michelle are in the lead with 32. Oh,
shot we are.
Okay, so it's a crucial conundrum. So sometimes, Michelle, on this show, we say it's a conundrum, and that just means it's a bit of fun at the end of the show. This is crucial, because there's less than 10 points in it. So they could win, or you could win. I mean, it's exciting.
It's double jeopardy!
It's not quite the Super Bowl, but we want to get you involved.
Okay. Order.
It's the Golden Shack!
The Elephant and Parade! Ha! Here we go!
I really thought we were getting something.
That went very quickly from an explanation to a fever dream.
OK. All right, fingers on buzzers. It's time for today's crucial countdown conundrum.
You got it.
John?
Bothering.
Why do the others...
Even what? Bothering to turn up when they know for surety they're going to lose.
Let's have a look and see. Of course. So the final scores are Jonathan and Johnny have a very respectable 29 points, but tonight's winners with 42, John and Michelle. Congratulations, you're now the proud owner of the Countdown Ball Pit. Thanks to all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Next Friday at 9, Channel 4, it's back. A bit of telly watching and the opinionated opinions flow. Brand new goggle box. Jon Richardson, he's doing us a favour Monday from 10, teaching us how to survive the end of the world. You laugh, but next tonight, that doomsday feeling, keep laughing. A drink every time Trump gets a mention. I'll get the kettle on. Live, last leg.